actually I found it really intriguing to read the book of Acts chapter 12. I'm very, very interested in finding it, and I just want to share with you guys about my findings. So today I'm going to talk about praise God really make things, the situation different. And I will use the book of Acts chapter 12 to show you two different people, two different characters in the Bible. So first one is King Herod, and second one is Peter. And let's see how they switch their situation by praising God or praising themselves. So there is a pretty dramatic finding of death of King Herod. And if you read in the book of Acts chapter 12, you know King Herod, he is basically always the bad guy. So he persecutes Christians and arrests them from the church in Acts chapter 12 verse 1. He killed brother of John in chapter 2, chapter 12 verse 2. And he put Peter into the prison in chapter 12 verse 4. And who is Peter? Who is Apostle Peter? Basically, you know, he is always being a righteous apostle of God. He is the righteous man of God. And let's just see these two different situations, how these two characters facing their situation and how they switch their situation by praising themselves or praising God. So situation number one, okay, King Herod, the one praised himself. In Acts chapter 12, verse 21 through 3, it's talking about on the appointed day, Herod, wearing his royal robes, sitting on his throne, and deliver a public address to people. They shouted, "This is the voice of God, not a man." Immediately, because Herod did not give praise to God, an angel of the Lord struck him down, and he was eaten by worms and death. So firstly, you look at here, okay, it is an appointed day. It's the most important day for Herod. And he was preparing all this stuff. He made himself to look really great. What did he do? He's sitting on his throne. You can imagine a throne, like it's pretty, you know, the golden decoration, the gold and everything. And he was wearing this robe, maybe it's super fancy. If you a sister, you maybe basically know what's maybe that about. So basically he's dressing so fancy in his life, and this is the most important day of his life. But live a life to praise himself. Have you been ever to wearing all these clothes and dressing really fancy to giving praise to yourself as a Christian? And sometimes I do, maybe myself, even now I'm wearing kind of this really fancy shirt. But that's something we really need to repent from, because as a Christian, we always praising God, not praising ourselves by decoration our body, or give us all these alternative belongings such as a mouse, a keyboard, all this stuff. Okay. And what's the consequence? Because he praising himself and he being even struck by the angels and by God, and he was eaten by the worms. Let's look at situation number two with Peter, the one who praised God. Okay, turn your Bible to the book of Acts chapter 12, verse 5. So Peter was kept in prison, but the church was eagerly praying to God for him. And if you turn to 11, then Peter came to himself and said, "Now I know without a doubt that the Lord has sent his angel and rescued me from Herod's stretch and from everything the Jewish people were hoping would happen." So basically, you look here, what was the situation for Peter? So basically, Peter is pretty desperate. He was being jailed by King Herod, and he had no way to really break the prison. He is not a talented guy, you know, it's what I'm saying. But he relied on God. This church was praising God, and this church was going to pray about the situation. And here, when Peter was rescued from the prison, he meets some people. He not say, "Hey, look at, I'm here, I'm very smart, see, the angel help me to open the door, unlock the door." He not talk about that. He is going to say, Paul, because it's no doubt that God used his power to rescue myself. Are you the character of Peter? Are you going to praise God when God deliver you from your difficulty? Okay. So what's the consequence? Basically, the consequence is just more people going to church, and the church is saying, wow, Peter's come back and he's not using his own power because of God. And because of that, those more people become a Christian. So in conclusion, okay, for today, we see both examples for men who believe in God, who praise God, and the man who praise themselves. And we know both the consequences, okay, which character you want to be today. So the challenge for today is that to gain praise God always. Not focus on yourself, but always have this grateful heart and praising God for delivering you from each difficulties.